As we mentioned in our conversation with Bill Gates, a Kaiser Family Foundation survey found that more than half of unvaccinated Americans think the vaccine is more dangerous than COVID. The Biden administration has come down hard on vaccine misinformation, but one Florida doctor has seemingly gone to great lengths to perpetuate it. 360's Randi Kaye now with a story, the hunt to find him and the reasons behind his actions.
It's an unproven vaccine. It's just being accelerated, eliminating virtually every safety study.
He is the ultimate super spreader, not of the coronavirus, experts say, but of misinformation about COVID-19. His name is Dr. Joseph Mercola.
It is very likely that most people in America, if not, you know, the vast majority of people in America, have seen misinformation that has originated with this super spreader of lies and misinformation.
That's exactly why the Center for Countering Digital Hate, a nonprofit tracking misinformation about COVID online, put Dr. Mercola, an osteopathic physician, at the top of its disinformation dozen. A list of 12 people, the group says, were the source for sharing 65% of all anti-vaccine messaging on Facebook and Twitter from February 1st through mid-March.
In a pandemic, misinformation has a life that has a cost that's paid in lives.
We tried to track down Dr. Mercola to ask him about the misinformation he's been posting, like masks may not work, vaccines could be dangerous, and vitamin C and D can prevent or treat the coronavirus. We first tried to find him at his office in Cape Coral, Florida, outside Fort Myers.
Yes. I'm looking for Dr. Joseph Mercola.
Not here.
Not here. Is he here today? Can I leave
no.
a message?
He's not here.
Will he be here tomorrow, if not today? Or
no, he's normally not here.
So even though his office is listed here, he doesn't work out of here?
No.
Okay. Okay, thank you.
Next stop, more than 220 miles away, Ormond Beach, Florida, which Dr. Mercola calls home. We found his house behind a large gate and tried making contact through the security access pad.
Hello, this is Randi Kaye from CNN. I'm hoping to get a word with Dr. Mercola.
Later, we spotted Joseph Mercola riding his bicycle. Once he stopped, we thought this was our opening to get some answers as to why he's pushing false claims about masks and the vaccine.
How are you? I'm Randi Kaye with CNN. Can we ask you a couple questions? We just want to talk to you about vaccines and what you've been saying about them. Do you feel responsible for people who didn't get vaccinated, possibly got sick and died because of what you told them about the vaccines? What do you say to families who lost loved ones? Are you spreading misinformation?
Nope.
Why won't you speak to us? Here's your opportunity to speak with us and answer questions.
So despite all his bravado online, Mercola suddenly had nothing to say. Though after we emailed him questions, he responded saying, I encourage every person to fully educate themselves to make individual decisions about medical risk-taking. Throughout the pandemic, he's been quite outspoken.
I wanted to go back to this, the reason why the mask may not work.
In his email to us, Mercola challenged any suggestion that he belongs on a disinformation list. Still, by fueling the narrative that vaccines are dangerous, who knows how many of his followers chose to skip the vaccine? This was Mercola on a podcast in April last year, saying vaccines are
being fast-tracked with and abandoning all safety precautions to the wind, I'm sure will cause enormous disabilities and premature deaths as a result of implementing this.
What Mercola hasn't made clear to his followers is that according to the CDC, the vaccines are safe and effective. And of the more than 345 million doses administered, there have been an infinitesimal percentage of serious adverse events conclusively linked to the vaccine. Though he told us via email that over 400,000 adverse events and 6,000 deaths from the COVID-19 vaccines have been filed, a majority of which were filed by medical professionals. To be clear, the FDA has not established a causal link to these deaths. Earlier this year, Mercola posted this outlandish claim, that vaccines, quote, alter your genetic coding, turning you into a viral protein factory that has no off switch. The CDC has said vaccines don't interact with your DNA. Mercola also posted an article he authored that states aerosolized hydrogen peroxide can be used as an at-home remedy to treat coronavirus. According to the FTC, there is no study known to exist that supports that. Yet via email, Dr. Mercola said the approach is one that many clinicians I've discussed have found provided a significant improvement to their patients. The danger in all of this is that Mercola's misinformation has reach. The Center for Countering Digital Hate found he still has 14 accounts on mainstream social media with more than 4.3 million followers. His website promises to deliver trustworthy natural health information and has had more than 37 million visits since January.
He wants to replace those doctors as the source of health information for people, because then he can recommend his cures.
His cures? Apparently, they include vitamins C and D. After Mercola posted an article headlined, "Vitamin C and D Finally Adopted as Coronavirus Treatment," which has since been removed, the FDA requested Mercola, quote, take immediate action to cease the sale of such unapproved and unauthorized products after noting he misleadingly represented the supplements as COVID-19 treatments. In his email to us, Dr. Mercola said he has responded to the FDA letter and asked to meet with them. And just today, Mercola announced he is removing all articles from his website within the next 48 hours.
The last week has brought a tremendous amount of reflections to me and a lot of unacceptable threats to a company. So the course of action I am now forced to take is to remove my entire archive of articles. 25 years worth of blood, sweat, and tears coming down.
So, Randi, does that actually mean he's shutting down his website and all the misinformation or information that he puts out there?
No, that will stay up, Anderson. He said he will continue to post articles, but they will now only stay up for 48 hours, and then they will be removed. But what he didn't say if he's going to share those articles and all that misinformation on his social media platforms, Facebook, YouTube, Twitter. So we reached out to those platforms to ask them what they plan to do about all the misinformation that he's posting and what they've already done. Twitter tells us they have removed tweets. They've also applied misleading information labels to some of them. Facebook says they have removed pages. They've also banned some of his pages. And YouTube says they've removed some videos, but still not enough strikes against him to remove him fully from the platform. But Anderson, I should tell you, to give you an idea of how many people follow this guy and believe his information, his misinformation, I should say. His new book, which I won't even tell you the name of, is now number one on Amazon's bestseller list. And I've spoken with experts about this, and they say that book, they've looked at it, is full of nonsense, Anderson.
Randi Kaye, appreciate it. Thanks.